So how do we solve logarithmic equations? In this video, we'll do four examples. Here's the first one. We have log base 3 of 5 minus x, and that's equal to 4. So to do this, we're just going to do 3 to that power and 3 to that power, because this way, this and that can cancel, and we will just have 5 minus x, and that's equal to. Look at this as 3 to the 4th power. Work that out, we get 81. And then from here, we can just solve a regular equation. So minus 5 on both sides, we get negative x is equal to 76, and then divide both sides by negative, so we get x is equal to negative 76, and then we are done. X is negative. Is this okay? Yes, because when we plug in negative 76 back here, we see we have log base 3, and then this is 5 minus the x is negative 76. But we do have this negative right here, right? So you see this right here is actually 5 plus that, which is actually 81. So this right here is just log base 3 of 81. And to calculate this, you can look at 81 as 3 times 3 times 3 times 3, which is 3 to the 4th power. So this right here is just log base 3 of 3 to the 4th power. And this and that can cancel. Therefore, we do end up with 4. So this right here checks. So if you get a negative number for x, don't worry too much. You always just plug into the original equation to make sure we do not have a negative as the whole inside. So this right here is actually a positive 81, so that was good. For the second one, well, let's go ahead and do the same thing. We have log base 2, so we do 2 to that power and 2 to that power. Cancel, cancel. Here we get x squared minus 7x, 2 to the third power is equal to 8. And now bring the 8 to the other side. So we have x to the second power minus 7x and then minus 8. And that will be 0. Factor this real quick. We get x minus 8 times x plus 1. And that's equal to 0. Okay. From here, we make this equal to 0. So we get x is equal to 8. From here, we get x is equal to negative 1. We have two answers. Are they both legit? Or maybe one of them is fake? Well, the way to do it is, you just plug back in and double check. So if you put 8 in here, we get log base 2 of 8 squared minus 7 times 8. Okay, what's this? 64 minus 56, which is 8. So this right here is equal to log base 2 of 8. Oh, interesting, so we get 8. But anyway, 8 is the same as 2 to the third power. So this right here is log base 2 of 2 to the third power. And then cancel, cancel. So we do end up with 3. Yeah, if you see a positive inside here, that means it's actually good to go. This is legit. How about this right here? Well, let's just go ahead and verify it. Log base 2, negative 1 back into the x. So we have negative 1 squared minus 7 times negative 1. Okay. So, here we get log base 2. This is positive 1, and this is plus 7, so it's 8. And you know this is legit, because we'll still end up with what we did over there. So this is okay, because both of them, we get the positive 8 inside. So both of them are legitimate. Therefore, we will just present both for the answer. For these two equations, notice that they both have two logarithms. But the good thing is that they do have the same base, so we can combine them right away. For this one right here, we have a sum, so we have to multiply this and that together inside. So we are going to have log base 9, and then this times that inside. So let me emphasize that we have x minus 5 times x plus 3. Okay, and then this is equal to 1. And of course, we can just work this out real quick. We get x squared, and then this times that is going to be negative 5x, and then this times that is going to be 3x, right? So together, we get negative 2x. And lastly, this times that is negative 15. Okay, so as you can see, we have this. The log is with base 9, so let's go ahead and do 9 to that power and 9 to that power, so that way this and that will cancel. And the inside is just that. So I'm just going to write down x squared minus 2x minus 15, and that's equal to 9 to the first power, which is just 9. And then from here, we can just solve a regular quadratic equation. Minus 9 on both sides, we get x squared minus 2x minus 24, that's equal to 0. Factor this real quick, we get x minus 6 times x plus 4. From here, we know x is equal to 6, and then from here, we know that x is equal to negative 4. Okay, here we have two answers. Are they both legitimate? We don't know, we have to check. And let's just go ahead and do this in our head, because remember, as long as the inside is positive, you know it's going to work out well. But be sure you plug this back into the very original, because the domain issue. So you always plug back into the very original. So here we go. When we put 6 right here, 6 minus 5 is 1, so that's good. And likewise, when we put 6 right here, 6 plus 3 is 9, so that's good. So this right here will work. Right? This right here will work. And in fact, this right here wouldn't work. Because when we put negative 4 in here, we get negative 9 inside. Right? So this right here, it's a no-go. The only answer is just a 6. Okay. Now, let's take a look at this one. We have a subtraction, so be sure when we combine that, it's going to be a division inside. So here we have log base 3, and then we have 10x plus 3. Again, the subtraction means that we have to divide by this, which is 2x minus 3. And this is equal to 2. Good. Okay, log base 3, we'll just do 3 to this power and 3 to that power, so that this and that can cancel. And we will have 10x plus 3 over 2x minus 3. And 3 to the second power is equal to 9. And this right here is just an equation, even though you have fraction, but it's an equation. You can just cross multiply or multiply this on both sides. You don't have to worry about like move the 9 to the other side and all that. That's only for rational inequality. So right here, let's multiply the 2x minus 3 on both sides. So be sure you do this and that. When you do this right here, they cancel. So we just get 10x plus 3. When you do this times that, you distribute. 9 times that is 18x. And 9 times that is minus 27. And then right here, let's see. Minus 18x on both sides. You know the good old business. Cancel this out. And then minus 3 on both sides. Okay, so we are going to get negative 8x, and that's equal to negative 30. And then here we will just divide both sides by negative 8. Cancel this out, and then we get x is equal to positive, and then reduce that by 2. We get 15 over 4. This is positive. When you plug back in here, this is positive. That's good. 15 over 4 is like 3.75. If you plug in back here, 2 times that and then minus 3 is going to be positive as well. So this is going to work. So the answer is x is equal to 15 over 4. So that's it.